one of the goals of the Brain Initiative is to push the technologies for allowing us to observe many neurons at the same time, which would be sort of like seeing what all the water molecules in the ice cube are doing. And you know, I'm interested in the development of theories that would build a bridge between what you can actually observe by looking at all the neurons and what the collective behavior of the whole network is. And so, you know, a million neurons at once is hard, and nobody's yet doing an experiment where they're observing a million neurons at once. On the other hand, there are people who are almost routinely doing experiments where they record from 100 or 200 neurons at once, sometimes in areas of the brain where plausibly that is how many neurons are actually relevant for something. And so my colleagues and I have been pushing to try and build models of that are good descriptions of the collective activity of, you know, we started with 10 neurons, and then we did 50, and now we're at 100 or 150, and we're starting to see the emergence of real collective effects, which we think are relevant for how the system works. And I think that if these experimental techniques are going to expand in the way that the proponents of the Brain Initiative imagine, then these theoretical questions become much, much more urgent.